Why does my armor looks worse in the end level screen than in game? That happens when you overdesign your character, I'm Arachne, as always, and I'm bringing you Super Turrican. I discovered to be pretty decent at this one too while streaming, so it was double the fun. I always tell people that when a game is hard but fair, I get into it, and after gimmick, it finally happened again. Let's go back to the story. I'll talk about only what I gather from this game because I don't know about the series' plot. The machine is a semi-human and half-robot that wants to conquer everything, planet by planet. He's already taken some, and you go to the next one in danger there to find 1 billion people turned to slaves. In what time? How did you do this? I've arrived as soon as I've known that you were coming to the planet, and you planted already all your things in the area too? Impressive! Let's get right into the gameplay. This is a run and gun game with very well done platforming elements. The control scheme is the first one to feel super comfortable too in 16-bit. Smartly so, they decided to make you jump with the B button, shoot with Y or X, and A got relegated for extra weapons duty. Let me tell you, this is how you make a game in this genre. Finally somebody understands me. The platforming is very good because it's button press dependent. The more you keep it down, the more you go up. Seems like many other games did it before, but it's different. It's a case of it being very granular and smooth. Even better than in Super Mario World, where in most games before this on Super Nintendo you could tell that characters are 2 or 3 heights for their jump. In short, usually they were settings, but in Super Turrican is really tied to the B button. Pressing it has this feeling of weight behind it, basically. The level design is very labyrinthian but not too confusing. The many unique elements will tell you where you are anyway. It's all very visually distinct, so you can map it in your head and I will be fine with that. There's no need anyway because, surprise surprise, Factor 5 put some exit signs telling you where to exactly go to finish the stage. Dear developers, was that hard? Because if yes, sorry, but I'll avoid your game. Come back, Factor 5, we need you, please! No, you're going! Okay. The only thing you need to be careful about is the timer. But here's another amazing thing. Every level has its own different timer appropriate for the length of it. Understood, Nintendo? And the enemies, there's some basic ones that come back every level and that's good, because you need some fodder in a run and gun. Then every stage has its own subset of unique monsters to blast away with joy. Of course, this is a game released before 2001, so it has to have some that look like the Xenomorph from Alien. It was a low, I think. One every 10 titles needed to do this or video games would stop existing. I'm pretty sure about that. The bosses are pretty fun, even if here comes my biggest disappointment with Super Turrican. The final boss is super easy if you have a specific weapon. I did the first try after all. Go to my VOD channel and look it up. Of course, near the end of the video, you'll see that this isn't edited at all. I was ready for an actual final level after that with other real final boss, but no, that's it. It's supposed to continue in a sequel, okay then. Since there's only 3 of them, let's talk about the weapons too. Seems to be not enough, but you can power up them all 3 or 4 times, so it's all good by my standards. The first one you'll encounter is a cross-game return, directly from Contra, the bullet spread. It's very useful because it makes the final boss piece easy, so use it. The second one is a ricochet ball that will be very useful when enemies spam bullets from a hard to reach angle. And for last, you get a straight shot that gets wider and wider. You'll think it useless, but you'll need it for the hardest level in the game, so there. Factor 5, gotcha again. Those tricksters! But that's alright, let's not get too granular. There's no need to become a pedantic video essayist now. Let's move into the artistic parts of it, because I can't wait to talk about them. The style is amazing. Everything has big sprites, including foreground and background elements. Ain't that great? Colors pop in a way that is really pleasing. Even with a million bullets on screen, mostly thanks to the spread, you'll never get confused as to what you're doing. I don't know how they did it, but the screen is always perfectly readable. Oh, what makes the style amazing? It's how they managed to mash some buttery smooth surfaces with the more square stuff that is very impressive. I know a lot of sprite work that is still straight up busted even in modern games. No, I'm being hyperbolic, but indie devs especially have trouble mixing round and non-round shapes together, even famous ones. In the most egregious cases, you can see some white or black space between them, not much here. It helps that a lot of elements on screen are constantly moving, to hide any imperfections, and it manages to always run at 60 FPS or more than 59.5 anyway. At the very end, tucked in the back of your mind but trying to constantly burst through, is an amazing soundtrack. Just non-stop action upon action melody that will pump you up in the most difficult spots. How to describe it better? Well, take the year 1993 and then say you're listening to the Rocky IV soundtrack. Yep, you got it. Maybe mix some Top Gun in there too for good measure. Strong bass, dominating rhythm guitar and overly sensual battery. Did I say sensual? Ah, okay, I didn't make any mistakes, good. And the big news is, it's the first console game ever to sport the ability to reproduce Dolby Surround, and yep, you can hear the difference. Especially if you use a good pair of headphones, and I'm not talking about earbuds. Don't use those unless you like to lose your hearing by the time you're 40. If you don't insert cotton swabs in, why do you think AirPods are okay? Enough lessons, I'm spicy today. I just finished this game and I'm pumped to the extreme. Just remember to concentrate on the music during the auto-scroll board. That will help you make it. Psst, fun little secret fact about my reviews. I rewrite them a lot, but always take the time to write something right after finishing one. So, back to reality. What's the deal with Super Turrican? Why is it only a 9 out of 10? Well, you see, like I said earlier, I was still very into it when it ended. Just an extra stage and a boss would be ideal for me, so close. But I will not be playing any other games in the series. I tried with Super Turrican 2, but this isn't my idea of fun. If you wanna see me play the games that I will review plus some extra stuff, catch me on Twitch at ArachneRetro. Same name that I use on Twitter where I will keep you updated with everything I am doing and more. See ya at the next review. Bye bye!